Today, on Attack of the Show, the battle has begun. The PS3 and Wii go head-to-head in the loop. Some love it, others hate it. We take a closer look at the PlayStation 3 on Game Break. All this and more on a live and feisty Attack of the Show, starting right now.
What's going on here?
Pick up on this.
Attack.
Attack of the Show, TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. It's Monday, November 13th. It's going to be a long week, a busy week. My name is Kevin Pereira.
It's going to be a great week.
It's an amazing week.
Hey, guys, I'm Olivia Munn, and we are coming to you live from the G4 Studios in L.A.
And the reason we're so excited, really, the official countdown has begun for the console wars.
This Friday, the PS3 will be released, and then 2 days later, the Wii will also hit shelves.
That means a week from today, both systems are going to be out. The wait is almost over. And now that we're actually this close, it's going to get ugly.
It's going to get very ugly. The battle is raging. People are going nuts. It is time for
Console Wars 06 Live!
Did you hear him going wild? Listen to that. Still fine hanging.
We're excited.
Oh, yeah, of course. On Saturday, Japan was really the site of the official PlayStation 3 launch. 100,000 consoles went on sale. Really wasn't that many. They're gone. They're always gone, of course. Crowds were already lining up days ahead of time, but once the doors open, all that customary politeness and order, it just started to crumble.
Yes, and then all hell broke loose. According to numerous blogs, Chinese immigrants and homeless people were paid to wait in line, and people working for the Yakuza bought a huge number of systems who will sell them for triple the price.
Right. I mean, I use 4 day laborers. They're in line at Best Buy at Westwood right now.
Are they?
Yeah.
Could you get me one?
Pennies on the dollar.
Could you get
Absolutely.
Me a Wii?
Absolutely. Now, again, gamers get screwed. The real people who want the consoles and want to play the games can't get their hands on
them. Yes. But now, from the videos we are about to show you, at least one PS3 won't be making it to eBay. Yeah, some Japanese guys were lucky enough to get one and then decided to dissect it like a frog in science class. No hamster wheel inside. It's actually a well-put-together piece of hardware.
Yeah, it took them like 5 minutes to get the case off the thing, but they uncovered the cell processor, the fan, which keeps it all cool somehow.
And quiet.
That's the amazing part. But the best part of the PlayStation 3 is that it's going to be like a hack fest. People have already swapped out the hard drives for bigger ones. The software is pretty much open source. People are saying you can install your own operating systems onto the thing. So at least right now, it sounds like Sony's like, hey, you know what? You spent $700. Do what you want.
It's yours.
Yeah.
Now, all right, enough with PS3 news. There's another console coming, and it is the Nintendo Wii. We have one, and we are going to play it when?
Right now. Yeah, we've actually been rushing through most of the show consciously
to get
right here. So for those of you who have been sleeping under a pile of rocks for like the last few months, here's how the thing works.
Yes.
Why don't you grab your remote there, sweetheart? This is the Wiimote and nunchuck attachment here.
Yeah. It's all sensor.
All runs off Bluetooth. You got to put on the wrist strap.
Because
it could go flying across the room and kill a house cat.
Or screw the cat. I don't want to break my remote.
That too.
You don't want to break
the remote. So we've got a plasma over here with the sensor bar, which can detect the remotes, you know, 10 meters away.
Which is really hard because we're probably like about like a meter and something away.
Yeah, give or take. We're about, I think, the average distance for most gamers. And, you know, you can have up to 4 controllers connected wirelessly. It's got some GameCube controller ports in there. But what's great is that it comes packaged with a game.
Yeah. Now, when you guys buy the system, you actually get a game with it. Wii Sports is inside the box, and it's probably the first thing that people will play. So we decided that we would fire up this bad boy and give you a preview of what's in store. There's 5 different sports to play, but Kevin and I... we're going
to
box.
Yeah, I know. I've been wanting to punch you in the face for like the last year and a half.
Go ahead.
And now we have the chance to really make it happen.
I'm excited.
So we got the game fired up here. We're going to go into it. And it's going to give you a little tutorial. Now, again, it's not like, okay, so let me explain to you 12 different buttons that you need to know for all these different things. You see your character reflected on the screen. Now, if you tilt the remote to the left or right, you'll see that your character also does that as well.
Yeah.
Raise your hands up. You're going to block your face. Keep them down. You're going to block the body. And then, okay. All right. I was demonstrating the body block, and now you're going to town. That's very classic.
I love that you don't have to push any buttons. You just get to.
No, you look like you're doing some Tai Bo, body boot camp. What are you doing? What's the workout you've been doing lately?
Boot camp. Barry's boot camp.
Barry's boot
camp. Every morning at 7 a.m.
And as you can see, like the remote has a built-in speaker, so with each punch that I throw, I actually get to hear the leather that Olivia's eating.
And it vibrates whenever you get knocked.
Right. Throw hooks, throw uppercuts. I think you can rabbit punch. If you want, I can actually grab like Tyson and pull
Shut up.
In
Do
to
that.
The ear bite.
Do that.
Hold on, I gotta get in there.
Hold on, I'll stay still.
But it's really cool. No, you can't. There's no ear biting, unfortunately. It'd be a nice feature. But there you go. And look at the cute little characters, Mom.
I noticed. I love it how like there's different characters you can pick from, and that one looks like me.
Well, no. It doesn't just look like you. It is you. This is the coolest thing about it. Notice, by the way, the little hand, it even tilts.
Oh, yeah, and then we can tilt in with each other.
We'll get to the main menu and we can do that. It's really cute. But what's great is that you take it out of the box. Everybody's like, play a game. Why don't you play Zelda? You know, play some Wii Sports. I spent 10 minutes making my Mii, which is a virtual version of yourself that you can use in all the games.
Well, no, I have to stop you here. I noticed that they're all called channels. We were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, very smart move by Nintendo for that, you know, people who aren't used to video gaming, they can pick this up and go, oh, different channels.
So user-friendly.
There's a game channel. Yeah. There's a sports and news. And so here we can go into the Mii creator, and these are all of the character. Oh, here we go.
So I gotta tell everybody, when Kevin first opened up the game, he didn't go play the games. He instead made a bunch of Mii.
Yeah.
He made his whole family and friends and everybody.
There's Kristen Holt hanging out. I actually didn't make that
with
one.
With a goatee. Hey, you got a goatee.
And then check this out here. Let me grab this little girl. Oh, look at her squirm. That's like when I grab a fistful of her hair in real life. Slam her against the screen a couple times. Out some aggression.
You leave little Olivia Mii alone.
No. I made this virtual version of you. You can spit
with
it around.
With freckles.
Isn't that cute? But we can go, and if you don't like that, you want like a botched makeup job, a little Tammy Faye.
Oh, I like the green one.
Going on there. We can change your hair up.
Can I have longer hair?
Yeah, we can do that. Let's get you some better
hair.
Can
I have my freckles back?
Done. I'll get you your freckles back. But you see, you could spend hours literally making yourself and your friends. And if you've got a Mii, or if you've got a Wii, and I have one as well, we can connect to each other wirelessly over the internet, and you can hang out on my virtual console.
And then you can do a Mii parade, and you get all your friends, you can march down, have a Mii parade.
They'll actually throw a parade. I'm so excited for this thing. It's fun, it's intuitive. Within 3 seconds, you're picking up and you're playing it.
Hey, Nintendo, send us some for free. But you guys at home, we're sorry if we made your wait worse. We apologize.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Kill some time at g4tv.com/AOTS so you can find links to everything you just saw. It's almost as fun as playing with it, honest.
I actually, my button unbuttoned in the middle of that from like boxing. I had to like kind of
really
tidy myself back
and
up.
Knocked the stuffing out of you.
It did, a little bit.
Busted the guts.
Yeah, well, I'm a
Nothing
pro.
New. Right now, folks, it is time for the only news that you need to know. So let me get Layla Kaylee with the feed headline.
That doesn't work on us like that.
Thanks, guys. Here's what's coming up in the feed. First, the PS3 was officially launched in Japan, and we've got all the details. Plus, Borat takes the box office and also takes a beating. And air guitar fans might soon be able to rock out for real. It's all coming your way in the feed. But first, back to you guys.
All right. We know you folks at home have a ton of questions about the console war, so we should probably answer them.
Yep, it is time now to check in with you guys in the Army of Monitor Heads. Here is Juan from California.
We know which one's more expensive, but which one will have better games this Christmas, PS3 or the Wii?
That's the first shotgun question we've had.
I know.
A question asked from the shotgun position. Very nice.
I like it. Now, the PS3 is for hardcore gamers, and it's basically... Right. It's like the PS3, it's like the PS2, but just looks better, it's faster, it's just
Yeah, if
better
you like
graphics.
The games on the PS2, you're going to find them on the PS3.
But the Nintendo is a whole new breed. I mean, you can't even compare it to other consoles.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about this controller. So I think that's what you're going to find is that, at least on the Wii side of things, all the games, he wants to know about, which game's going to be better. I mean, better or worse, it's really not fair. It's very apples and oranges. But these are going to be a little bit different, something that you haven't seen before, which is nice.
And aren't most PS3 titles already available on other systems? Like Call of Duty 3 is already out.
Yeah.
Tony Hawk's Project 8. I mean, which you can't even take online with the PS3.
Yeah, and that's a valid argument. People say, well, you could get the 360, which is, relatively half the price, and play some of those titles, which, at least right now, they pretty much look the same. Mm-hmm. There's nothing more amazing about the PlayStation 3. I played a little Ridge Racer 7.
Yeah.
Okay. Gundam not looking so hot.
Well, are there any big games for the PS3 that are coming out that you have to get?
A lot of people are saying Resistance Fall of Man is that game. And I've only spent milliseconds with it, so I'm not in any position to judge it. We'll have Adam on later in the show who's played it at length. He can tell you if it's really that good. But I'm definitely excited for the Wii. I think that for me, the games are more exciting on that one, at least right now. So
much fun.
All right. Even though we have some questions about the PlayStation 3, we know it's going to sell out. Mm-hmm. People are already waiting in line. And this console war obviously is going to have a huge impact on the future of gaming. But really, do gamers want a sophisticated system with multiple applications, or do they just want to have some simple fun?
Well, we want to know what you guys think with today's poll question, PS3 versus Wii. who will come out on top. Vote at our website, g4tv.com/AOTS, or text your vote to G4TXT, that's 44898, to vote and register for AOTS Live News Alerts.
Right, now coming up later, folks, you don't have to wait until next summer to get your first peek into the much-anticipated Spider-Man 3. We're going to have the brand-new trailer for the surefire blockbuster later in the show.
Now, Spider-Man 3 may be the most anticipated film of next summer, but right now on TV... Welcome back to Attack of the Show. We are live and talking PlayStation 3 versus the Wii. Before the break, we asked you... PS3 versus Wii, who will come out on top? Well, most of you must be Nintendo fanboys, as 61% of you think Nintendo's Wii will top PlayStation 3. Let's go on over to Kevin, who, like the Wii, is both cheap and fun.
That is true. In just days, you can finally get your hands on Sony's PlayStation 3 and Nintendo's Wii. Now, the PS3 is trying to blow you away with graphics and its fancy cell processors. The Nintendo Wii, on the other hand, wants to offer you and your grandmother a totally new gaming experience. But... who is going to come out on top? Welcome to the next level. I missed that. It's The Loop. Joining us tonight from San Francisco, senior editor for Games Radar, Christian Nutt is here, and contributor for Electronic Gaming Monthly, Johnny Gibson. Welcome to The Loop, gentlemen. Christian,
hello.
I want to start with you because it sounds like, I mean, Nintendo has everything going for it. We've heard for months now they've been producing these consoles. They're cheap. They've got the innovative controller. How can the PlayStation 3 stand a chance when even our own polls are reflecting that people think the Wii is going to win?
Well, the PlayStation had a lot of bad press, you know, going up to the launch, but it's a fantastic system with fantastic graphics. It's much more technologically advanced, and it should pave the way for... 5, 6, maybe 10, if they want more years of gaming.
Now, do you really think that Sony will be able to get 10 years out of a console? I don't recall a manufacturer ever getting that much life out of a system, really.
Yeah, I don't know. It's difficult to say. It really depends on how things go with the 360, because obviously the Wii is paving a different path. I think they can coexist just fine, the PS3 and the Wii. It's all down to Sony versus MS.
That's true. Now, John, some people say that the Wii, at best, it's a slightly improved GameCube with a controller that's going to get gimmicky within seconds. I mean, is that a fair assessment?
It's a glorified GameCube, yeah. The graphics aren't up to par like PS3 or 360, but it's fun. Like, Christian doesn't mention the fun of Wii. PS3 has hair follicles with 20,000 polygons in it, but is there fun? Is there a community aspect to it?
But they flow naturally, John. That's the thing. Be it wind tunnel or just a casual sword fight, the hair flows naturally.
And they have pores and real-time pimples, but it doesn't matter because Nintendo knows...
It doesn't matter?
It does not
matter. I think it matters.
You think pores matter?
Did you, you know... I don't think pores matter. I think excellent graphics matter. These games transport you to different worlds, show you things you couldn't see, and at HD resolution. So I think it's going to be really hot.
But compare something like Gears of War. It's a resistance. Like, there's no comparison there. Like, Gears has the simplified gameplay with that visceral action that you want, and
yeah,
resistance
let's touch on Gears of War for a second, Christian, because when people go to the Best Buys and the Toys R Us's of the world, and they see Gears of War next to the PlayStation 3, I mean, it's comparing a launch title, you know, lineup, to a title
right.
That's had years in development. So some would say that's not fair, but does the average consumer know that or care? I mean, is the PlayStation 3 in trouble during its holiday launch season?
I don't know. I think that, you know, sure, there's been negative buzz on the net, but I think a lot of people love PlayStation. Gears of War has been lavished, you know, no expense spared. You know, I'd compare Resistance to, say, Perfect Dark Zero, see how we feel about that. They have to compete.
No,
they
that's a much fair comparison,
yeah,
and most people aren't willing to make that one. Now, John, do you compare the Wii to the PlayStation 3? Because you said it's all about fun for you, but can you compare the two types of games available?
I don't think necessarily it's that fair, but I spent the whole weekend with friends playing the Wii and hitting the Wii Sports and hitting the Zelda and doing some Excite Truck. And it's just fun. It's this community aspect of gameplay that we kind of lost. Like, remember the days of Super Mario Kart with Super Nintendo? Like, you had four friends in the living room, like, yelling at each other.
And now you can strangle them
with the cord, too.
I'm getting misty. No, you're supposed to use the included wrist strap, and again, don't hurt other people in the room. Nintendo's being very clear about that.
But it's all about the choking, Kevin. It's all about the choking.
I know you're a big fan of the choke, John. Christian, you know, people have said they're hoping to get 400,000 units to North America for this launch window. I mean, I think it's a no-brainer that this is going to be sold out. People won't be able to get their hands on it, even if they want it. But what's the outlook for, let's say, January through June of next year? Will the demand still be high for the PlayStation 3?
Well, I mean, let's look at the, you know, the how the 360 went. the 360 demand was consistent across last year. And, I mean, the PlayStation, people love the PlayStation. I think the demand is going to outstrip supply for some good long time, especially as better games start coming out early next year. We're talking like Heavenly Sword and Warhawk Reign, all those games that people are really looking forward to that use the six-axis controller, you know, stuff like that.
What is it, $600, $800? Like you need the system that bad when you got the Wii for $300 with a game, basically?
Yeah, that's, I mean, they're very different. It is a lot of money, but it's delivering a very high, you know, technological appeal.
It's an
like
investment that could pay
thing.
Off down the road, and I think that's the risk that Sony's hoping
I think it will,
people are willing to make. And I agree, I think it will as well. But right now, though, it's a question of who's going to win, but I don't think we're going to answer that just yet today. I want to thank Christian and John for keeping us in the loop. Listen, the battle of the PlayStation 3 versus the Wii is not going to be decided by fancy processors or gimmicky controllers. The battle will be decided by whoever has the most innovative and entertaining games. So remember, the console war debate, well, it doesn't end here. All this week, we're going to be chatting gaming in the loop. But right now, we're going to our own motion-sensitive mun.
Thanks, Kev. Today, we are bringing you tomorrow's big... Welcome back to Attack of the Show Live and living it up in the gaming world. So right now, let's get some hot coffee with Mr. Kevin Pereira.
I do love me some coffee, Olivia. I like it hot and black. But never mind, it's time to make sense of the gaming stories that matter the most. Pause your Gears of War co-op matches, okay, put the controller aside, because it's time for today's game break. Here to discuss all things gaming, co-host of X-Play, the expert himself, Adam Sussler. How
Thank
are you, sir?
I'm doing all right, and you?
Good weekend of gaming. I had a great one.
Pretty much, this is the only thing that's happening that's not involving Gears of War right now.
All right, well, let's get into it. We're going to get to Gears, but I want to start first with something that Nolan Bushnell said. Recently, he sat down with a media company, Red Herring, for an interview, and when asked about the PlayStation 3, the former president of Atari, I think he's the founder, had more than a few words of wisdom for Sony and its upcoming console launch. In the interview, Nolan Bushnell says, quote, Sony has shot themselves in the foot. There is a high probability they will fail. For years, Sony has been a very difficult company to deal with from a developer standpoint. This is Nolan Bushnell.
Yeah, he also, I think as we're saying, called them arrogant and capricious.
And he said that they could be that because they had such a huge installation base on PlayStation 2 that they could treat developers however they want. And did that game change? Is this still the case with Sony?
I'm afraid that Sony still behaves this way. I mean, a lot of it just... You know, there's so much about what's happening now that's very similar to what happened at the launch of the PS2.
Right.
You have cutbacks on the number of, you know, all these big promises that don't seem to be delivered on. The big one being 400,000 down from 2 million is very significant.
Sure.
I think like the high cost, and it really does seem like that developers are getting some of the same difficulties that they had at the launch of the PS2. The PS2 launch was I remember hearing from a lot of developers that they weren't getting the support, they couldn't figure out how to work the architecture.
Neversoft couldn't get their game online because they don't have the online library.
I know.
Is this Sony being rude and being arrogant, as Bushnell would say, or is it they simply don't have their act together?
I think there's two different ways. There are ways in the position that I'm in. I feel that I have dealt with Sony sort of arrogance that you know, there's certain facets of the press out there that they would just not deal with.
Right.
Though I think also it's a very big company. Mm-hmm. And we know that from the development of the PS2, and I imagine this is also similar for the PS3, you have a Japanese and American division. Guess what? They're not always in agreement with one another.
Sure.
And it's just, it's that big and kind of unwieldy.
Sometimes Sony America doesn't even know what announcements are coming out of
it. I mean, the idea of the singer going like, oh, let's give those developers a hard time and make the product suffer. I don't think they're saying that. At the same time, I think that it's a large bureaucracy and they can't get the kind of support that I think some of the other game companies do offer.
All right. Next up is the general manager from EA Montreal. Okay. So he was, while speaking about at the panel at the Montreal Game Summit, he shared his thoughts on the Xbox 360 and the little title called Gears of War that we've been chatting about. He said he thinks Gears has been overrated and that the title is lacking in terms of any real innovation. So now, of course, gamers are up in arms, especially when it's an EA employee talking about lack of innovation.
Yeah. And it's in Montreal.
Yeah.
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 Pot kettle black, or is he right? Is this true? Like, there's no innovation.
Okay, I know one thing. Gears of War is hella fun.
Yeah.
It's one of the best times I've had with the game. I do think on some level it's innovative. When you take a step back, you're like, okay, I am kind of doing the same thing over and over again. Mm-hmm. But when you're in the thick of
it, doing in that moment.
Yes, and it's so well thought out. I don't know. It depends what people consider to be innovation. Mm-hmm. It still has a lot of trappings with traditional games, which I think is fine. I think I don't know what people keep on thinking that they want from innovation.
Sure.
In terms of the game that I think might break more boundaries, BioWare's Mass Effect is what I'm currently thinking might really be that one. But that's not.
But with
the
all that said, and very quickly here, is the chainsaw kill perhaps not the most satisfying way to defeat an enemy in any video game ever?
You know, Rumsfeld's going, "Oh, I should have thought of that one. I would still have my job."
He would too.
Yeah,
by the way.
Chainsaw kill. Wow.
The curb stomp as
well.
Cecily, thank you for coming on
my
and chatting video games, folks. We will continue covering the hottest gaming stories every Monday right here on the Game Break. But make sure you tune in. You got to check out XPlay's exclusive PlayStation 3 preview show. Adam Sessler will be there along with Morgan Webb. It's coming up right after Attack of the Show here on G4. For more information, you can check out g4tv.com/xplay. But right now, it's Miss Olivia's turn.
Now, as all you gamers out there know, this Friday, the PS3 will finally be available, and G4 will be your only source for all the excitement with our three-hour exclusive special, PS3 Day 1. It kicks off with a two-hour Attack of the Show special, followed by must-see episodes of X-Play and Cheat. Buckle up, because we are giving you live demos of Full Auto 2 and Resistance Fall of Man. Zach will be reporting from the PS3 New York City launch party, and we'll have an exclusive interview with the president of Sony himself, Kaz Hirai. Now, from the Blu-ray to reviews to strategy tips, join Kevin, Adam Sessler, Morgan Webb, Kristen Holt, Will, Zach, Layla, and I as we show you the future of gaming. It all starts next Friday right here on G4 from 6 to 9. And for more information, head on over to g4tv.com/PS3. Now, when we come back, we are talking to James Bond. Hey!
What was that? Let them know what they dismissed. What was that last part? The blah blah blah.
We sometimes do a little bit of a web thing from Kevin's home, and we don't know the name of it yet. So it's like Olivia and
Kevin's
fun time on Wednesday nights, and watch us from Kevin's apartment. We're coming up with news.
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. Attack of the Show. We're live, and last night I curb stomped an 11-year-old.
I'm guessing you played Gears of War during the whole Emergence Day event, then, right?
No. No, I didn't play Gears yesterday.
So,
coming up tomorrow, we've got a brand new DVD Tuesday. We'll check out the Strangers with Candy flick, find out who killed the electric car, and even, we'll have the longer version of King Kong. Did someone really ask for that?
I would never have asked for that.
Oh.
It was pretty damn long in the beginning.
Yeah.
Now, we'll also go in your pants for the sex relationship advice that will keep you relatively normal, and on Wednesday, we'll show you some ladies into peace, love, and top eights. We're trolling the web for hippies and are going to crown a new MySpace girl of the week.
Totally. Finally, though, it's time for the further adventures of everyone's favorite web slinger.
It is the trailer for Spider-Man 3. Peter Parker's back, and he is pissed.
MJ to marry me.
A man has to put his wife before himself. Can you do that, Peter?
Yeah, I think I can.
We have some new information. This is your uncle's actual killer. We lost his trail 2 days ago.
This man killed my uncle, and he's still out there.
Everybody needs help sometimes, Peter. Even Spider-Man.
Revenge is like a poison. It can take us over. And before you know it, it can turn you into something ugly.
The suit. Where'd this come from? The power. It feels good. You lose yourself to it.
Whoa.
Spidey, love the new outfit.
Remember Ben Parker?
What does it matter to you anyway?
Everything!
Do you want to push me away?
Why would I want to push you away? I love you.
You knew this was coming, Pete.
I didn't kill your father!
Terrible things.
to each other. We have to forgive each other, or everything we ever were will mean nothing.
I need your help. I have to stop it.
This could be the end of Spider-Man.
Yes!
Okay, is Tobey Maguire not the most awesome Spider-Man ever?
Oh, that's what I'm talking about.
I can't wait. I love the black suit.
The third movie in any franchise or series of films is always supposed to be like the death knell, but this looks like it could be the best one.
It looks like the best one.
There's that shot of like pressing Sandman's face against the subway train when it comes by. It's always been like a fetish. I wanted to try it when I was in Japan. I just never got the chance to, but now I see what it looks like, and it looks awesome.
I like when he punched through him and he's all sand. God, I love that movie. Now for all the things you guys saw today and more, go to g4tv.com/AOTS.
Yes, but remember to stick around for X-Play's PlayStation 3 preview show with Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb. It's going to happen right now.
Right now.
But right now, like in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There it is!